Dear ladies and gentlemen, thank you for attending this presentation. My name is Manuel Casal-Guisande. I am a predoctoral fellow at the University of Vigo at the Department of Design in Engineering. And today I'm going to present you our work entitled A Proposal for Using Haptic Contour Parametrical Models in Cobb Angle Determination. We're going to divide this presentation in 5 points, starting with the introduction to the problem. Then we are going to explain you the grounds of haptic contour models, which will be used later in our system. In point 3, we propose the system that we will be developing in the point 4 in the implementation. And then finally, in the section 5, we will present the conclusions after doing this work. So scoliosis might be defined as a spinal deformity. An example is shown in figure 1 over an X-ray image of a patient. It's important to say that its early diagnosis and treatment are fundamental in order to correct possible degenerative effects that its evolution can cause. It's important also to say how this can be diagnosed. There are several ways in order to assess the severity of the curvature, but the most common ones are based on X-ray studies, calculating after that over then the Cobb angle. The Cobb angle can be determined in several ways, as can be manual way with the use of a pencil and some kind of drawing tools. There are other computer-assisted ways where the user over a computer will draw some lines and will be able to calculate the angles. And finally, the computer-automated way in which you give the image, the X-ray image to the algorithm or to a computer, and a program will determine itself which is the value of the angles. So our goal here is to automate the Cobb angle determination process using an approach based on an active contour model, which is commonly known as a snake model. So we are going to start by the grounds of these models, the active contour models. The idea is that starting from an image, we want to apply some kind of segmentation techniques in order to identify some kind of contour within the image domain. It's basically an optimization problem where an energy function will be minimized once or when it reaches the contour of the object we want to segment. The thing is that starting, as can be seen in the figure 2a, from an initial contour, the algorithm will iterate once it reaches the contour and getting the minimum for the function. This energy function must integrate several information regarding or related to the characteristics of the image, as well as to the shapes. We are going to use, as I told you, the snake model. Snake model is a parametrical model. And we will start, as can be seen in the equation 1, with an initial contour, depending of the space, that is the space domain. And then we will define an energy function, as can be seen here, the equation 2. The idea is to minimize this energy function. And it is composed, that equation, the equation 2, of several elements. On the one hand, we have the internal energy. The idea is that the internal energy will control the curve's elasticity and rigidity. Okay. Then, regarding the external energy, it will make that the curve moves to those features that we want, as could be seen some kind of edges or structures. We could add also another term that is related to some kind of external forces that the user might want to add. So once we do that, the idea is, in order to minimize the function, that the internal energy is equal to the external energy. As can be seen in the equation 7, we have the balance of energies or forces. And in equations 8 and 9, the definition of each term can be seen. Well, in order to solve that equation 7, the model will treat the curve not only depending on the position, but also in the time. So a partial derivative of the equation will be taken respect the time and will equal the left side of equation 7. So The numerical solution for the equation 10 that we are showing here will be reached after its discretization, solving the discrete system iteratively by means of finite difference techniques. So, what is our proposal? Well, our proposal is that starting from an X-ray image, we will make some pre-process over the image in order to make it easier in the snake stage to obtain the contour. Okay, we will obtain a processed image. That image will be given to the snake, and the snake, taking into account the initial points given by the user and some kind of configuration, will determine the spinal contour. That spinal contour will be used to determine the spinal curvature, and finally will be used applying some kind of trigonometric functions to determine the Cobb angle. So, we have implemented this on MATLAB. You can see here some screenshots. On the left, in the first image, you can see the initial step where the image is loaded and before applying the transformations over the image. First, we apply RGB to grayscale and a rescale process. After that, we crop the image and we make some other applications of filters in order to prepare the image for or adapt the X-ray image for the algorithm to make him or well, to make the algorithm easier to determine the contour. Then that image is given to the snake, okay, and the snake will be taking into account the initial points given by the user and the parameters. You can see in the image in the right that we can define the value of alpha, beta, gamma, kappa, the weight of the line, edge, etc., which can modify the behavior of the snake algorithm. That information related with the internal and external forces we have been speaking about. So after the snake is used, the contour is achieved. This contour will be used in order to determine the spinal curvature, and over that spinal curvature we will apply several trigonometric functions in order to determine which are the degrees as can be seen in the image. So, as we can see, in this work we have proposed the possibility of establishing an automated method or way to determine the Cobb angle, which is based in the use of active contour models, in this case applying the snake models. We have developed an application in MATLAB which shows how easy it is to work in order to determine this angle with this software we have developed. And at the end, we would like also to say that if this system is implemented within an information system applied to the healthcare or in a medical environment, will make easy to make better and faster decisions regarding X-ray images analysis, reducing also the diagnosis times and making faster or accelerating the treatment and prevention stage of these patients. Finally, I just would like to thank you for your attention, and if you need something or if you have any question about this work, do not hesitate to send me or to drop me an email. Thank you very much.